Man, this tracker won the game. This tracker was a huge deal. That mattered way more than I thought it would. We are back. We are here for round two after soundly stomping a red-green Ponza, spoiler alert, in round one, of course. And yeah, I mean, if this list looks confusing to you and you're like, Valakut Awakening? Excuse me? Guttural Response? What the heck? Well, you need to check out match one, where I describe in detail what the heck is going on here, how we got to these card choices, and I will not be going over that here because the show must go on. We are going to hop right in here for match two. All right, let's just hop on in here. You don't want to see that. You don't want to see my recording setup and my face. Of course not. Get that out of here. This hand could use literally any one drop and also a bounce land. No thanks. This hand has Valakut Awakening, so it actually has everything it needs, even though it doesn't necessarily look like it. All seriousness incoming. Don't need this explosives. We have strings to find additional lands here or to find an amulet, hopefully. And Valakut Awakening. Oh no, explosives, come back! Come back, engineered explosives. I changed my mind. We need you. All right. Strings. That's not an amulet. And you order that stuff and send it back. Well, humans is not the deck that we wanted to see on our opponent's side of the table, but we'll deal. Are they just gonna just yellow slam I was gonna say, are they just gonna slam a Meddling Mage naming Dryad? Because that would be pretty interesting. They get to take our Valakut Awakening here, which is, that's just rude, if you ask me. Ultimate rude. Alright, let's play this Garenbring and pass it back. Now, let's see if our opponent is stopping us from casting Dryad. I see white. I see blue. Meddling Mage. Oh, Mantis Rider. Okay. I mean, that's not great, but at least we get to actually start casting cards. That'll be nice. Imagine when your opponent's creature aggro deck stops you from casting your spells. Unreal, am I right? Completely unbelievable. All right, let's get this Growth Chamber into play. Pick up this Crumbling Vestige. Pass it back to our opponent. Tighten off the top, please. Opponent, no Meddling Mage. The upside to playing three Talaria West here, though, is not only do we have plenty of access to the explosives that we did just bottom, but we can also transmute for Valakut, which is very tech. Valakutting away our opponent's board of humans, I mean, I would love nothing more than that. And they're going to freebooter away the freshly drawn sorcery that we just found. A classic. Definitely wouldn't have it any other way. All right, all this just doesn't matter. Primeval Titan, please. Primeval Titan. Come on. You know what to do, deck. Cooperate. Primeval Titan. I'll take a Summoner's Pack, too. I will settle for a Summoner's Pack. Valakut Awakening. That's just a little too slow, isn't it? We are just dead on... No. We're 1 point of damage away from being dead on board, which is basically the same as being dead on board, because they do have... things like Thalia's Lieutenant and stuff like that. So I guess... like, what do we even do here? What can we find with Valakut Awakening? Like, double amulet. We can put back Vestige, Dryad, and find exactly double amulet plus Primeval Titan. No, even that doesn't do it, right? Wait, we play one amulet, bounce land, float two... second amulet, bounce land again up to 5 mana. Even that doesn't actually do it. Yeah. Opponent said lag check. Trying to see if I have outs. I don't think that we do. I mean... I guess our opponent could also not have the human to buff their team. We could also find something to target our opponent's copy of Mantis Rider. It's like maybe we find Slayer Stronghold in an untapped land. Maybe that is our best out, is to try to find Slayer Stronghold here. I don't know, though. Whatever it is, we got to use this Valakut Awakening. The problem is, I don't know what all we need to... what all we need to find here. Like, I think we need to keep the Crumbling Vestige, as this is already an untapped source, but... makes us dig one less deep. I think we just put that back, too. Alright, we need Untapped Source and Slayer Stronghold. Let us get those cards. That is not it. Alright, we are going to game two. Let's go ahead and take a peek here. All the explosives, come on now. All the dismembers, heck yeah. Don't know if we want Force for this matchup. Our opponent can obviously destroy us without Aether Vial. Definitely want Sage, though, for if our opponent does have it. Tracker to play around the Meddling Mage, of course. I don't know how I feel about Force. I feel like it's probably not good enough. Baloth, I'm not really interested in. We can Trim a Pact. Bog's out. Cavern is out. Awakening. I mean, it's like alright, but it's a little slow. I think we can Trim. I think we can Trim on Awakenings. Let's get rid of... Azusa is pretty good against them, actually. In fact, maybe we don't want Awakening at all in this matchup. I could see that for sure. We don't really have time to be casting this spell, sadly. And one more card. Stirrings helps us find these explosives or amulets that we would be looking for. Could just be a Titan. That's kind of crazy. Grazer seems very good here. Our opponent does have things like Thalia, Guardian of Thraven, so maybe Stirrings is a little weaker. I'm going to Trim one Stirrings, and I'll run it back this way. Alright, we'll be on the play, of course. Alright, we have a turn one amulet. We have Bounce Land to go with it, but we don't have any ramp. We do have explosives, though, which our opponent can see with and take with their Freebooter, so... probably worth keeping, I think. We'll play Amulet and then immediately play Explosives on 2 on our turn 2 so it doesn't get freebootered. Freebootered. I don't know if I can even say that word. There goes Amulet. Pass it back. See if they have the one mana Accelerant, Noble, or Aether Vial. No, not even a Champion of the Parish. Well, that's fantastic news for us. All right, let's get this Explosives on 2 out of our hand before our opponent can take it. Done. Pass it back. All right, now we can go Garenbrig into Growth Chamber and immediately be able to cast Titan 2 turns from now, which is actually fantastic for us. Now we just need to find the Titan in 2 draw steps. You think we can do it? I mean, we can't counter our opponent's human spells. Whatever shall we do? Alright. This damage sphere is quite annoying since we do have just multiple copies of Bounce Lands just chilling in our hand here, but that's okay. Let's play... I guess the Garenbrig? Maybe Vesuva is a good one here. Let's play Vesuva copying our forest. It is possible for some humans' opponents to be playing Mages of the Moon. I have encountered that in the past. But this helps us play around that a bit. Guess we don't want to be yielding here, just in case. Damping Sphere definitely does hurt our opponent some here, though. Maybe them having Damping Sphere suggests that they're not playing Mages of the Moon? We'll see. Here comes a Meddling Mage, perhaps. Nah, Mantis Rider. Alright. Alright, we'd like to draw a Dryad here. Please and thank you. Dryad. Tyos Tracker. I'll take that too, actually. Into play. Let's go with the Stomping Ground. We'll get a clue here. And pass it back. Tracker is decent here. Could be better, could be worse. At least it lets us dig a little farther for cards that we can use. Our opponent's on a bit of a slower draw here. Reflector Mage. That's kind of annoying. Not much we can do about it. Maybe we'll find a second of our four explosives to play on three and blow it up. Azusa. I mean, that is definitely an accelerant, so let's get that one into play. We'll go Garenbrig and Gruul Turf, I suppose. And we'll pick up this... I think our opponent's not on the Mages, so I'm going to go ahead and pick up the Vesuva. Can't play Tracker. We can go ahead and crack a clue. I think we should. Another Explosives, huh? Don't want to use this for mana. All right, let's just go ahead and play Vesuva. Copying the Valakut here, I think, makes a lot of sense. Holding up Explosives for two, so we can blow it up. Yeah, just pass it back. We can also use Explosives for two to unlock all of our mana. That way we can, like, play Tracker, play Bounce Land, crack a clue, and still have another Bounce Land or two to play for the turn, and maybe cast a Titan if we draw it, so... Probably is going to be worth cracking Explosives here. Lieutenant, you got it. Of course, we're going to do this on our opponent's instep. Probably not blocking with the Azusa here, since we need our multiple land drops here to kind of get back from this. Dryad is also another fantastic top deck. Let's pop this Explosives. Untap. It's not what we were looking for. Let's play this Tracker. Play our Growth Chamber and get some triggers. Let's float a bunch of mana. Crack this clue using the red. Yield. Okay, not that. All right, let's leave our mana in play, I suppose. Let's do it again, because if we find Titan on this draw step, then we can then play Bounce Land and cast it. So let's go ahead and crack the clue. Anything good? Dryad. That's fantastic. All right. Well, we're definitely casting that one. Let's keep Bounce Land in hand here, I suppose. I'm cool with that. Let's leave our blue sources in play. All right. Let's play the Heath. We'll kill this Mantis Rider, as that one does have flying. Get rid of it. Always yes, always yes, always yield. And this is why we had the Vesuva copying Valakut in the first place. They have the Dismember. This is why we played the fetch land, because now we can fetch for a land and go ahead and get something dead out of the deal here. Let's get a basic land, though. Play around what we can. Want to kill the Mantis Rider. Dismember resolves. This Tireless Tracker is huge. I mean, I don't think we can afford to attack. Probably need to threaten to block this Tracker. I mean, block with our Tracker against this Reflector Mage. So hopefully our opponent doesn't have another Reflector Mage. But, I mean, we can always just crack. I guess we missed 1 point of damage potentially. But we can just crack Clue on our opponent's instep. Again, trying to find Titan. Oh no, another Reflector. Come on. All right. We're still not dead. I still think we need to keep this Azusa in play. So, all right, let's crack this clue immediately. Titan. Nope. Titan. There we go. We also might be able to just kill him with Dryad, with two, three, a billion land drops. Yeah, let's just go for the Dryad and kill them outright. All right, let's start with a land drop. Shoot you. Man, this Tracker won the game. This tracker was a huge deal. That mattered way more than I thought it would. All right. Yeah, I don't see a reason to change anything, so let's run it back. I just now realize our opponent's name is Yo. That's probably not how they say it, but that's how I say it, at least. We'll keep this hand off of the idea that our explosives is pretty good here. We can also find an amulet with our stirrings, and that would be great. They have the one drop this time. Aether Vial. All right. So, if we play Forest Explosives on one now, we can de-accelerate their hand. They only get one activation of Vial, but it's going to take up this turn and our next. I think that's probably fine, though. So I'm going to go ahead and just solidify that plan. Need our opponent to be as slow as possible for us to make it out in the clear, I suppose you could say. Able to get Radiant Fountain value here, too. That's pretty nice. Man, that tracker was insane. Freebooter, taking in our stirrings. Like, okay. Don't love it, but I mean, what else could we do? It's a good thing we played out this explosives. Whew, amulet. We need to pop explosives before we get our amulet in play. So that means playing a Radiant Fountain and popping explosives right now. We don't care about getting a 2-for-1. We just want to slow our opponent down. So that's the plan. And we're going to be definitely playing Amulet this upcoming turn so that we can have Garenbrig out and then the turn after be able to play Gruul Turf and immediately cast Titan. Unless our opponent has Meddling Mage here, which it looks like they do. Finally, the card that we've been scared of this whole time comes into play. We'll see if this name's Dryad or what. They do name Dryad, not knowing that we have the amulet because they did not see it from the kite sail. So that's actually fantastic for us. All right. I mean, we still have to show them the amulet, sadly, but so they need to have a second Meddling Mage or a Phantasmal Image, or it's pretty much over. Looks like they do have it. Gross. Okay. Someone's going to be naming Titan, obviously. Okay, now we need a lot of help. Now we need a Dismember. Engineered Explosives. There's another Vial. Okay. Our opponent has a very slow clock so far. Even our Radiant Fountain is relevant here. Azusa is a castable spell, I suppose. Do we want to have Bounce Land in hand here? Kind of a tough call. We may need a bunch of mana on one turn, depending on what we draw. Like, so we can, like, Valakut Awakening into more things and continue to go off. So I think having the Bounce Land to go along with this Azusa is pretty valuable. Probably worth more than 2 life. Hopefully we don't eat those words, but Valakut Awakening would be great at helping us find another Explosives or a Dismember or something here, giving us effectively additional outs. You can also Pact for Tracker. Mantis Rider. All right, so this is going to increase our opponent's clock pretty significantly. Not blocking. All right, something good. Third Uncastable Titan is not really what we were hoping for. Okay, well, I mean, now we're basically just dead. We can still top deck Explosives for 2. And maybe kill our opponent even from 16 here with the Double Strike plus the Haste. That would be great. Explosives is our best draw, I think. Assuming our opponent doesn't have a third Meddling Mage. This is why Humans is generally a bad matchup, though, is this card right here. Another Mantis Rider, okay. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. No. They have the Lieutenant. Alright. Don't know if we're even surviving this turn. Let's see. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yeah, we actually have no way to win. Alright, well, that's the game. Would we have hit the card that we needed? Nope. All right, well, not surprised to lose a match against humans, of course. At least we got one of the games, so I'm proud for that. And, yeah, I mean, even though we had four explosives and three dismembers in our deck, we still had trouble facing down the freebooters and meddling mages and mantis riders of the world. So, humans, definitely a bad matchup. Let me know what your tech is to beat humans. I did consider playing some fire spouts in the sideboard, although I don't even know how good a fire spout is against humans, in all honesty. Like I said, let me know what your tech is. The tracker definitely seems like it does a lot of work against humans, surprisingly, so... If, like, we had drawn a Summoner's Pack for Tracker, play Tracker, draw a bunch of cards with, you know, Azusa making mana and clues and stuff, I could definitely see that being a winning line in situations like what we just saw. Anyways, I will see you guys for the third match in the next video. This is Redface Menace, signing off.